Hey guys, Dagan here from PMT UK, and what I got for you today is something brand new and exciting. This is a new feature called Rock and Shop. What is Rock and Shop? Rock and Shop is interviews with our favourite bands, artists and musicians, but it's more than just an interview and a gear guide. It's finding what instruments they use, why they use them, and to show that these instruments are accessible. You can watch your favourite bands on the TV or live and get their gear on our very walls. And I have the pleasure today to chat to the magnificent Death Blooms.
You wanna fill my body.
So I'm here with the guys now, and you must be buzzing. You've had a great start of the year. You've just got the back of the tour with Shapes and your own little headline tour. How was that for you guys?
Yeah, it was really cool, man. It's just good to get out and do some of our own shows and stuff as well. So, Shapes Run was really cool. You know, good guys, good bands, good crowds as well, man.
Yeah, so, yeah. Cracking, man. Yeah, well, you guys are supporting your new album, which came out in the middle of April, wasn't it?
It was the end of it. EP came out at the end of April, yeah.
How's it been received? Is it good?
Yeah, really good.
On Spotify, you've got thousands of listens.
Yeah, it's up to like a quarter of like a million streams, so
that's absolutely
that's sick. You
got that badass video for Crosses as well,
which
is a bit terrifying, I'm not gonna lie.
Good.
All the masks in there,
good man.
It's pretty intense. I mean, some of the context of the songs go quite deep, don't they? Do you guys think of an idea then write songs around it, or think of like a badass riff and write the words to it, or how do you guys go about writing your tunes?
It kind of depends, really. I think, you know, we kind of sometimes it's we'll have riffs and we'll kind of base songs around riffs or whatever, but then sometimes it's just been like a chanty idea or something as well, you know what I mean? So it's kind of whatever, I think the hook, whatever the hook is, ends up being, whether it's a riff or a vocal, ends up being like the kind of structure of everything.
That's so cool. I'm so glad it's been received really well, and you guys have a show coming out at the end of the year, don't you? You're doing like a little homecoming show, because you guys are all based in Liverpool and Manchester, aren't you?
Yeah. Well, we've not done a Liverpool show in a long time, so it was...
Nice little homecoming show.
Yeah.
Bringing our mates in the 500 as well.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Absolutely. They were on the Shapes tour, so yeah.
So you want to give a little plug. When is this homecoming show then?
It's on the Friday the 6th of September at the Zanzibar Liverpool.
So now we're going to talk to the guys about their gear, why they love it, what they use. So let's start with Ad, who's a guitar player. It's impossible to... These are amazing looking things, dude.
They are, man. That's why I've got them.
Hell yeah. Is it kind of number one, number two, or how do you set up with these guys?
So, like, this is the one that I fell in love with. Mm-hmm. Custom 24, wide fat neck. This one I use for Drop A. Mm-hmm. And as you can see, it's got EMGs in there.
Yeah, man, what flavour EMGs?
It's the Zach Wilde set.
Zach Wilde set.
We got the 81s, man.
Very nice.
Yeah, handles the tuning perfectly. Mm-hmm. And drives my amps well, man.
I mean, speaking of tuning, those are like pretty chunky ass strings. Yeah. What flavour strings are these?
So I'm using the Ernie Ball baritone strings. Mm-hmm. So that guy is a 72 right
That's
there.
That's mental. That's mad. I've never seen one of them on a PRS before. That's crazy.
Neither
I'm guessing
you've
had to drill through the...
Yeah. They had to drill through there. That, you know, it was never going to fit through there. So they drilled through a little bit of modification, but it handles it perfectly.
I mean, they are beautiful guitars, as we all know. And it looks like you gig this proper.
Yeah.
There's a few little war wounds on it. It's cool to see our PRS with a few little marks.
Luckily, the top still looks intact. But when you turn it round and you see all this...
Yeah, it's how it's supposed to be, though.
Yeah, man.
And what's the lovely lady at the back there?
Number two over here, another charcoal burst, of course. Mm-hmm. But this one is a 5708 limited edition McCarty. Everyone's going to shout at me, but it's got EMG 81s in again.
Dude, it's a great idea.
It sounds killer. It's drop C tuned, 56 up here. I don't think I had to get this one drilled out, so it's just perfect for the tuning, man.
Yeah, man.
I got a little shallow Hannah's bridge on there,
very
rather
cool.
than the standard, but you can intonate it. Perfect for the drop tuner, man.
Dude, they look so cool. So live, you rock these guys, but I have seen on a couple of your videos, you have a lovely Les Paul, don't you?
That is a 1976 Gibson Les Paul Custom original.
So nice.
The reason why I got it, I just like the heavy Les Pauls, man. Yeah. The backbreakers, I just feel like when you hit a chord, it resonates, man.
Yeah.
And it just feels like you're holding a guitar, you know? It's great.
Yeah. Well, have you ever gigged with it? Would you gig with it?
I
was it too precious or too heavy?
It's actually in the Crosses video.
Yes.
So
videos are okay.
You can see me struggling to jump around with it in that video, but I just use it for recording, man.
Yeah. So part of this whole Rock and Shop thing is finding out why people use certain brands. You're obviously big on the PRS thing. What drew you to these lovely guitars?
when I was a kid, there was a lot of bands coming up, like Limp Bizkit, POD,
Like the new metal resurgence.
Those guys all had PRS. Mm-hmm. I just thought, what is this beautiful looking guitar? Yeah. And it must be perfect for the sound, so I want one.
Simple as that. Who were your favourite players back in the day? Who used these guys?
Wes Borland. Obviously, mm-hmm. You know, in the Boiler video with that black PRS.
Oh, hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah, man. That's amazing.
So good. Marcos from POD, mm-hmm. of course, you know. And Jim Root from Slipknot.
He had a couple of PRS back in the day.
It was a tasty one, that.
Amazing things.
My heroes used them.
Talk about that. That's going to be the case for a lot of these videos, I reckon. My heroes use them, and that's why I use them.
Exactly.
Right. Awesome, man. So moving on, signal chain-wise, to this beautiful pedal board you've got now. Would you mind talking me through the signal chain? I can see it starts with something very cool, which is...
Absolutely. The bass wah.
The bass wah for guitar.
Yeah. The main reason for it, it sounds killer. It's got that sub-sweep at the bottom.
Oh, the frequency ranges are just mental when you play guitar through one of those, man.
It's crazy.
If you haven't tried it, come into a PMT store and try one out for yourself, because it's absolutely mint.
I saw a monkey from Korn using one of these. They use, you know, drop A tuning as well. And I thought, I've got to give that a go then. Maybe it's good for the tuning. And yeah, it's a blessing. I've been using one ever since.
Hell yeah, man. So that into one of the cleanest whammies I think I've ever seen.
Yeah, I was playing a festival yesterday. It was very muddy. All of this was covered in mud this morning. I thought I'd give it a little clean up for this video, man. Now, everything else is looped mm-hmm. into the Boss ES5, mm-hmm. Just so that I can do everything with one click of a button, you know, no more tap dancing. Mm-hmm. I've got the Mobius for all the modulation, mm-hmm. mainly chorus effects and phasers and things like that. The delay pedal, we play to a click, mm-hmm. so it's all just, you know, tempo match to our song.
Yeah. So you're going from this lovely board into your amp of choice, which is to your left, isn't it?
Yeah, the dual rectifier. I mean, they sound heavy as hell, don't they? Mm-hmm. They handle the low tunings. Channel 3, which is the heaviest thing. Yeah. They got channel 1, which is crystal clear clean.
Is it all just kind of the early noughties new metal thing?
It is, man. My answer to why do I use PRS guitars is the very same as this.
Yeah, I mean, I thought as much, man. With a lovely PRS next to a Meta, you just picture a certain genre of a certain time. It takes me way back. Hell yeah. So with the new metal rig that you kind of made in your head, what would your dream rig be?
The dream rig is what you see here, man.
I can't think of anything better for this kind of thing.
It's perfect for it. Like, you know, this is our sound, mm-hmm. and nothing else will do, really.
Well, it sounds great and it looks great. Thank you so much for your time.
Cheers, dude. Thank you very much.
So I'm here with Giz now and one of his two amazing sandbag basses. Ryan, talk me through this beautiful bugger here.
Yeah, no worries, man. This is my VS4 Sandberg bass, mm-hmm. and it's all kind of relic'd up and beat up. I've got two of these. The other one that I've got is a VM, which also has like the Music Man style pickup as mm-hmm. well. I run two different tunings, so that's why I'm kind of using two basses at the moment. Mm-hmm. This one is in drop C, and the other one is in a really low drop A to sort of, you know, get them riffs in and compete with Ads' guitar. So on the drop A one, I am using a 145.
You've actually got them there. Do you mind showing us the strings? I'll grab the bass.
Yeah, sure, man, yeah. So, so I'd get like a regular four string set, like a 45, 105, mm-hmm. get rid of this little string here, mm-hmm. and then put one of these bad boys, which is a Daddario .145, really heavy string on there, so I can tune down to the low A.
And obviously these come slightly relaxed. How much of that is you, would you reckon? Because you're quite hard on your basses, aren't you?
This is relatively new, this bass out of the two for me. But yeah, we definitely play hard, so
Man. So what makes you choose these basses? Why Sandberg for you?
Okay, cool. Well, I first actually came across these basses in this very shop. Mm-hmm. I spend quite a lot of time in the shop, so basically just played on them, really loved them. You know, absolutely sort of fantastic build quality.
They sound awesome.
And then as soon as I kind of got the call to kind of go try out with Death Blooms mm-hmm. and play with them, I kind of thought straight away, you know, I just had to get one of these. So absolutely killer basses.
So this is a very simple pedal board you've got, but it sounds amazing, doesn't it?
Nice and easy. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of all I really need. Tuner and then the Dark Glass B7K. So yeah, that's where all the drive kind of comes from for me. I've even done gigs where just straight DI out, mm-hmm. just, you know, get a decent monitor, and this is literally my bass amp.
Yeah, the Dark Glass things are so amazing. Really versatile, and they're indestructible as well.
Yeah, so nice and simple. Just two pedals covered in beer and all sorts of...
Just as it should be?
All sorts of muck and spit and water, and yeah, that's my pedals.
So you've just said we're in the right place for the amps that you choose.
Yes.
You have one of these lovely guys, don't you?
That's right, yeah. So currently running the orange Obi-Wan 500 head through 410 cab. Yeah, I mean, these are a really great amp. Just using the clean signal.
All the drive from the Dark Glass.
And all the drive comes from the Dark Glass, yeah.
Very cool. What made you want to go down the orange route? Because there's so many different bass amps out there, especially in somewhere like this.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Why orange for you?
Ah, they're just killer. They just sound awesome. And the orange, man.
They're so
orange.
Cool. Yeah. With this, though, there's so many bits of gear out there, guitars, basses, pedals and whatnot. If you were to compile your dream rig, what would it be?
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with the stuff that we're kind of working with at the moment. Like I say, the orange amps are great. The Dark Glass pedal is awesome. I think, you know, maybe some more of these basses, maybe some more of these guys. I think a nice gold one would be really cool.
Gold sparkle?
We want a gold sparkly Sandberg, yeah.
Very nice,
That's going to be the Giz signature.
Giz signature. Nice one. Thanks so much for your time,
cool, man. No worries. Good to see you, man.
We're back with Danny, who's the drummer in Death Blooms, and you're a Mapex guy, aren't you?
I am indeed, yes. I've used Mapex for as long as I can remember. A lot of my favourite bands, you know, the likes of Chris Adler from Lamb of God was using these for years. He's just, they sound great, they do the job. The kit I'm using now I've had for years and it's just not failed me at all. Originally when I first bought it, I started with just like an 8-piece or something, two kicks, all the toms you could ask for. Now I'm using something a lot smaller, one kick, one tom up top, two floor toms, and a lovely sledgehammer snare by Mapex, one of the Black Panthers. Beautiful, loud, brash, cuts through everything.
Very, very nice.
Just what I need for this band.
Yeah, man, speaking of cutting through though, cymbal-wise, what are you rocking for those?
So I've used a mix over the years. Started off with your Pisces, your Sabians, Stags, Zildjians, everything. Now I'm predominantly Zildjian. Got a few Sabians in my kit now, but Zildjian just, they do it. They... Something's right about them guys.
Yeah, well, they've been doing it long enough. They certainly know what they're doing.
Yes, they do.
And what are you hitting this lovely kit with? What's your stick of choice?
Promark 808s, yeah. Big fat round tip, fairly light, quite a fat stick.
Very, very nice,
too. Nice and comfortable.
So the last question I've got to ask you is, what would Danny's dream rig be? What kit would you have?
I would go undoubtedly with a British Drum Company drum kit. Yeah, absolutely. It's a company based out of Stockport. They started over the last couple of years. They hand make all the kits, and the craftsmanship and the love that goes into each of these kits, you just can't really ask for more. They sound incredible.
Fantastic, man. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Cheers, dude. So thank you so much, guys. That was great. Thank you to all your gear, the stuff you use, and obviously your amazing new EP, which is out now. We are filth, isn't it?
You are filth.
You are filth.
But, you know, we are as well. So
awesome, man. And at that Liverpool show?
Friday, 6th of September, Zanzibar. So
nice one.
Get your
thank you so
in.
Much, guys. Get your ticket.
Nice one, man.
Cheers.